Hi, I'm Krista Smith, and welcome to The Corner Booth. Today, I have joining me Noah Baumbach and Adam Driver. He's the writer and director of Marriage Story and one of the lead actors in Marriage Story. Great to see you guys.
This is the thing. He needs to know that I fought for him.
You wanted it until you didn't. You used me so you could get out of L.A.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. What is...
What's this?
It's a manila envelope, love.
Ooh, can I start over?
It has my name on it.
Ooh. Oh, Jesus. Sorry. You're served.
The scene in the kitchen when you get served is like one of the best scenes on film. I love that scene. I want to know about directing that and acting in that. How much rehearsal? Because it's so physical. It's actually right. Like almost madcap in a way.
Yeah.
How much rehearsal went into that before you actually shot it?
It's all extensively rehearsed and blocked so that everybody knows exactly where they're going. I mean, and
we actually rehearsed it in a different house.
We had originally in a different house as Sandra's house in a different kitchen, and we rehearsed it and blocked the whole thing. And then while we were shooting, that house fell through. So we had to then transpose the blocking into a new kitchen and a new house. I mean, it was difficult, I think I sort of justified it. It was sort of like we were all where Charlie was. He was both in a familiar place and a not familiar place. So that's sort of how I justified, like, oh, this will be good for the movie. But it's all, you know, very blocked out. And like you say, I thought of that scene on one level like a screwball comedy, like something from the 30s and 40s where people, His Girl Friday, where, you know, people are going to come in and out. And so on one level, it does have this sort of madcap, but then also there's this very serious... envelope. The other way of looking at it, it's almost like a thriller, that there's like a bomb hidden, you know, under the table, and the audience knows. And I love that if you can find that in a scene where you have these very conflicting genres or sort of emotional content, but then I think when they work together, it can be thrilling, and it becomes a high wire act of sorts that, you know, it takes these kind of actors to pull off.
I don't know, I'm sorry.
I was gonna warn you so it didn't become a thing, I'm sorry.
I feel like I'm in a dream.
I hate to use the word bromance, but you've worked together four times, right?
Yeah,
I just used
right.
it.
It's
I went for it. Because it is a unique situation when a director and an actor work together over time. And I want to just talk about, like, what is your collaboration like? What is it like to work with each other?
Like, Adam will call me about a movie three movies ago. He'll call me and say, like, I think I know now how to do that scene. And, you know,
that's
even though it's, as far as I know, we can't go back into Francis Ha. But I guess you can. But I find he's always thinking about it. And he's thinking about things that are long over. He's thinking about what we could do in the future. He's thinking about what we're doing at the moment. You know, it's my favorite way to work because it's so alive and the characters start to feel that much more real. And that's why, I mean, I only knew, you know, three things about this movie. You know, I had some notes, some ideas, and I brought them to Adam just even to hear what he would have to say, his immediate reactions, so that, you know, when I'm writing it and thinking of him doing these things, it's like another way to get deeper into the material. You know, I have what I'm drawing from the world, but then I'm also thinking of Adam and Adam's physicality. And I don't think I would have written these scenes. I know I wouldn't have had I not, you know, had him as a kind of guide, both, you know, on the phone and sort of in my mind.
Noah as a director and as is kind of the whole thing. He's someone that works on something how I kind of like to work on something. There's no detail that is unimportant. I'm not being very specific, but it's because it's kind of more of a feeling when you meet someone or you want to have a bromance with you. It just feels familiar in a way that, like, you kind of dream that that's what it's going to be like. And then with working with Noah, it is. It would not be a career wasted if we just if I just found a way to work on his movies until I die.
Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair to ruin your sleep. It's true.
Adam, when you read the script and you got about three quarters of the way through and you realized you were gonna have to sing, what were you thinking at that point?
Well, I knew that we were talking about being alive, being the song for a while. So but I didn't.
The whole movie is just me reverse engineering.
I mean, that is like, alive. Yeah. I was gonna ask, but yeah. I was like, Noah, he like figures out a way to.
I concocted this whole divorce thing so that Adam could sing being alive at some point in the movie.
And that's not true.
I felt like one of my tasks was, you have to arrive at this moment and make it satisfying and great and make it and give it a real reason to be, because when he does it, it's going to be amazing.
What's great about Noah as a writer and director is knowing when to have people say the thing, and then when a song is maybe a better way for these performers to express that. So I thought it was just a really great moment in the script. And then, you know, separately, obviously, it's terrifying because it's being alive. Yeah. It's Sondheim, it's like, you know, one of the great songs.
What did you learn from being part of this film, like acting it, doing it? Course of it. Have you learned anything yourself? And for you, I know it's deeply personal. Have you come out the other side with any kind of, I think differently today than I did a year ago?
Well, I see it. I say what's gratifying about showing it to people is I see it reflected back in a way. In talking to people about it, I do feel a kind of more of a shared experience of the movie than maybe I have in the past.
To echo what Noah is saying, it's just how it almost feels like I'm outside of it at this point. So it almost, it's beyond any ownership of any one person to create something that's bigger than any one of us. Have those conversations that we've been having with people afterwards. It's kind of like, I don't know what you can ask for better than that. Noah created this thing that, you know, creates space for dialogue. And that's been really exciting. So, well, I guess I've learned that that's rare.